iPadOS 17 beta is here and it's already making things better.
The iPad doesn't go through massive transformations year to year, but it continues to slowly evolve. The latest version of iPadOS, expected to arrive finished in the fall, as it always does, is in public beta now and available to download. I've been using it on an M1 iPad Air, and so far it's been a pleasant experience with a few clear benefits out of the gate. Downloading public beta OS software is always a bit of a risk, though, and for sure you should back up your device and data before doing this if you're curious, but beta software is also becoming a lot more of a standard way that all software works now. Regardless of the beta's benefits, you should probably still wait until the final, more bug-free version is ready later this year. Stage Manager, Apple's multitasking system for the iPad that parallels what's on the Mac, comes closer to feeling like the macOS version. On iPadOS 16, I found Stage Manager to be weirdly restrictive of how you arrange your four app windows on the iPad. I only found it useful when connected to an external monitor. In iPadOS 17, you're still limited to four apps on screen at one time, and Apple continues to restrict the sizing and position of apps to some degree. But the options are a lot more fluid. I can drag and stagger apps more easily one by one, from narrow panes to flat panels to larger, nearly full-screen options. Apple also gets other interface junk out of the way, allowing the Stage Manager dock and Apple's iOS app dock to minimize so you can fill the screen with just the apps you want. On an 11-inch iPad, that's extremely useful.
The iPad doesn't go through massive transformations year to year, but it continues to slowly evolve. The latest version of iPadOS, expected to arrive finished in the fall, as it always does, is in public beta now and available to download.
Savesec893@miclab.com. It's surprising Apple didn't have its health app on iPads before iPadOS 17. It's become a key repository of medical and fitness information, medications, and tons of other insights. The iPad version works the same way as the iPhone app does, just on a larger canvas. Mood logging, a new iOS 17 feature, is here as well. If you feel up to it, you can mark down how you feel any moment and tag what is connected to those feelings. Similar features have been on other health platforms like Fitbit, too. Even though there's a health app, the iPad won't pair with the Apple Watch. An iPhone paired with your watch can relay the data, and the health app should show relevant details like heart rate, blood oxygen, fertility tracking, and sleep, but the Apple Watch's activity ring information and achievements aren't here. Apple also has a journal app that's coming later in the year, promising therapeutic daily day logging, mixing writing, photos, and other daily activities, but it's not part of the iOS or iPadOS 17 public betas. It's surprising Apple didn't have its health app on iPads before iPadOS 17. It's become a key repository of medical and fitness information, medications, and tons of other insights. The iPad version works the same way as the iPhone app does, just on a larger canvas. Mood logging, a new iOS 17 feature, is here as well. If you feel up to it, you can mark down how you feel any moment and tag what is connected to those feelings. Similar features have been on other health platforms like Fitbit, too. Even though there's a health app, the iPad won't pair with the Apple Watch. An iPhone paired with your watch can relay the data, and the health app should show relevant details like heart rate, blood oxygen, fertility tracking, and sleep, but the Apple Watch's activity ring information and achievements aren't here. Apple also has a journal app that's coming later in the year, promising therapeutic daily day logging, mixing writing, photos, and other daily activities, but it's not part of the iOS or iPadOS 17 public betas. Subscribe to watch more videos.